If you're wondering, should I upgrade to macOS Monterey? Then this video is for you. There are actually a few things you should do before upgrading any OS, and macOS Monterey is no different. So here's what to do before upgrading to macOS Monterey. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today I'm sharing the 5 things you should do before you upgrade to macOS Monterey, and I'll include a couple bonus tips at the end. So let's go. Step number 1, check compatibility. You're gonna need to make sure your device is capable of running macOS Monterey. So with just a few clicks on support.apple.com, you can find a whole list of computers that are compatible with macOS Monterey. So I've included this link in the description below, but generally, you're going to have a device from maybe early 2015 and later, but that does differ depending on the computer you have. So it is key to check this list. And if you're still wondering, well, shoot, which device do I have? Just click on the Apple logo in the top left and then select About This Mac. In this pop-up, you'll see the device you have. Step 2, make sure you have enough free space. Sounds easy enough, but you really do want to make sure you have space prior to any OS upgrade. So once again, using that handy Apple link found in the description, we'll get a snapshot of how much space macOS Monterey will take. It's gonna take anywhere from 26 gigabytes to 44 gigabytes, depending on whether or not you're upgrading from an earlier release than Sierra. So to check how much space you have left on your drive, click that Apple logo once again in the top left, and once again, select About This Mac. Then from here, select Storage, and you'll get a snapshot of the storage space left on your device. Step 3, check app compatibility. This is huge. This is massive. Do not upgrade macOS before knowing if your third-party crucial apps are compatible with Monterey. Because here's the thing. When I upgraded last time to Big Sur, some of my apps broke. They weren't compatible at all. Now, what do I mean by some of my apps broke? Well, some of the third-party apps and some of the plugins I use for editing either didn't work at all, they were completely useless, or they were broken, meaning only certain parts of the apps work. So trust me, learn from my mistake and make sure your third-party apps are compatible before upgrading. So here's how to do that. The best way to check this is to go to the app manufacturer site directly and then dig around for compatibility information. So as an example, I'm gonna use Camtasia here because I use Camtasia to screen record all my videos. So if I go to the site, I can click on full system requirements to see a complete compatibility list. Now beware, for certain apps like this one where they don't actually name the macOS, just the version number, the app could still have some issues like I've had with Camtasia. But some third-party apps like Adobe Creative Cloud will tell you specifically which version of macOS it's compatible with. And keep in mind, sometimes this could be weeks or months after Monterey is available. Step number 4, back up your Mac prior to upgrading. This is absolutely crucial. This goes along with step 3 hand in hand. If I had to pick the top 2 things to do before upgrading any OS, it would be these 2. It's really important to have an up-to-date backup before upgrading any type of software, regardless. In the off chance that something does go wrong during the upgrade, then you have a way to go back to your most up-to-date backup. So here's how to do that. There are a couple of ways to back up your device, but my preferred method is to use Time Machine. This is really easy to do. You just need an external hard drive, and when you plug in your hard drive to your Mac will instantly recognize the device and ask you if you want to use it as a backup disk. Now, if this doesn't automatically happen for you, the pop-up doesn't show up for some reason, you can just head to your system preferences and select Time Machine. And then from here, click on Select Backup Disk, and then simply follow the prompt to use that external hard drive as your backup disk. Now, I like to actually keep Time Machine up in my top bar here for easier access. Now, backing up can take some time depending on how much storage is used on your device. And that leads us into step number 5. Ensure you have enough time to actually properly upgrade your OS. So first of all, like we just went over, backing up your Mac could take time. Luckily, you should still be able to work while backing up, but it can slow things down for you a little bit. Second of all, downloading macOS Monterey is going to take around 40 minutes, give or take. Again, you can keep working during this initial step, but things might be slower for you. Most importantly though, once you hit install, you want the installation to complete without putting your Mac to sleep or closing its lid. So I recommend starting the entire process maybe at the end of your workday so you can just let your Mac sit and take its time properly installing the upgrade. Now with this said, I do have 2 bonus tips for you. First, no matter which OS you are upgrading, whether it's macOS, iPadOS, iOS, whatever it may be, maybe consider waiting until the next version release prior to upgrading. Here's what I mean. If we go back to our About This Mac section, you'll want to take note of the version number. So for instance, I'm running macOS Big Sur, but it's version 11.6, meaning the first iteration of Big Sur was version 11. So there's already been at least 6 other patches to Big Sur that I'm running, or little updates, if you will. So for macOS, Apple updates the patch version for every release. This is really important to understand because these patches contain really important supplemental updates. So oftentimes what happens with brand new releases is there can be bugs in the operating system. So if you wait until version 12.1 to upgrade to macOS Monterey instead of doing it right away at version 12, you could help yourself out by avoiding those initial kinks and initial bugs in the system. And this brings me right into the bonus tip number 2, and that's to keep Monterey up to date. Because like I said, with these patches, yes, they're fixing bugs, but they're also adding security updates, which is really important. It's crucial to keep your macOS up to date. So those are my steps on what to do before upgrading to macOS Monterey. And now I want to hear from you. Have you upgraded to Monterey yet? Will you? What steps do you take before upgrading OS? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more content like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time. How many times can I say macOS Monterey, macOS Monterey, macOS Monterey?